Kiambukwa Boys High School started off as Kiambukwa Intermediate School at Kiambukwa, about 4 kilometers from its current location. During the emergency period, the school was burnt down and later it was moved to its current location.
My name is Peter Masharia Mashina. I'm the principal of Kiambukwa Boys High School. I took over the administration of the school last year, that is in April 26th. Since I took over the school, I found the school has systems which are working. It's now moving on from where I got the school from. In terms of enrollment, when I look at the history of the school started from very humble beginnings during the colonial times. And I understand that the school started elsewhere, where it was burnt down, and let alone it was brought to the current place. Through the land on which it is studying in was donated by members of the community, and it was opened in 1959 by the then colonial governor Sir Ivarin Baring.
It was registered on 20th January 1962 under the sponsorship of the Anglican Church. In 1969, the school had no students, but even the attempts to offer free education funded by the Gariama Farmers Cooperative Society did not yield much fruits, as in 1971, there were only 5 students. The school now boasts a massive enrollment of 967 students. It has also grown from a single-stream school to a 4-streamed extra county school today.
The school started not as a mixed school, but as a boys school. Then later on in the early 80s, it became a mixed school where girls were incorporated. Then late 80s, the girls were phased out. And now in early 90s, now it became a purely boys boarding school.
The last decade has witnessed tremendous growth, both discipline-wise and academically.
My name is Joseph Kagiri Mude. I'm the Deputy Principal Administration in Kiambukwa Boys High School. This school has been improving, particularly in areas of discipline and academics. Particularly the issues of discipline, we must say that we are blessed here because we do not complain about discipline, because our boys are extremely disciplined. In fact, we really have issues of suspension or even expulsion from this school because our boys are very, very disciplined. As far as academics is concerned, we have good strategies for the improvement agenda, and we are targeting this year, which we are calling the year of divine favor, 7.5 as mini grade. And the strategies we have put so far, we are geared towards that, achieving that target, because we have put enough strategies. We have issues like Kesha, where students learn even up to late evening. We have family groups, where different families, students are put in families, and they are one teacher. And we have discussions. We have given them very many exams, and therefore we are hopeful. And for sure we know that we are going to be a giant in this area, because we have put good strategies for this school under the leadership of our principal, Mr. Peter Mchina.
In 2011, the school, through the initiative of the Board of Management, launched its first strategic plan, via the roadmap for the running of the school in 2016. The second 5-year strategic plan in its third year runs up to 2021. This plan spells out the standards which the school strives to achieve.
My name is the Reverend Professor Kabiru Agatumo. the chairman, board of management of Kiamotogo Boys High School. I've been a chairman for the last 10 years. And when we took over the management of the school, we as the board resolved that we cannot go where we don't know where we are going. Because if you don't know where you are going, many loans can lead to where you are going. And so it is that time we resolved to have the first strategic plan for the school. We implemented the first strategic plan, and now we are running on our second strategic plan, which has about 6 objectives. But the first one being the improvement of our academic standards. And we believe that in everything we do in this school, it is meant to enhance the academic achievement of the students. We are moving on now. The 2016 to 2021 academic plan is still in progress. We have a few year remainings, but we keep on checking our strategic objectives and how much we are moving on and how much we are achieving. Since the strategic plan emphasizes so much on academic clinic, we always do an evaluation every year after every exam, where whether we improve or we lose, we always go for a retreat to map the way forward and to ask ourselves why. And the strategic plan is being implemented well. And I want to take this opportunity to thank the principal and the teaching staff, because actually they are driving force for the implementation of that strategic plan.
There are several well-organized departments under which the academic programs are run. Each department is headed by a head of department who is in charge of the smooth running of the activities. These departments include the academics, languages, mathematics, sciences, technicals and humanities, boarding, clubs and societies, guidance and counseling. Kiamotogo prides itself in its many infrastructural developments. The school has 2 workshops, 3 science laboratories, a library, a dining hall, and an ultra-modern administration block that hosts a number of departmental offices. All the 967 boys are hosted in the 10 dormitories. There is also a biodigester project that is in construction. Once complete, this will go a long way in providing cooking gas to the school, thereby cutting down on fuel costs in the kitchen. In the school farm, there's a pig project and a dairy project that ensures the school is well supplied with milk. There is also a thriving coffee farm. The school has 23 TSC teachers, 15 BOM teachers, and 20 permanent support staff who help in the smooth running of the school. The school has represented the county in the regional and even national championships in music, drama, and sports.
The school has 23 teachers who have been employed by the Teacher Service Commission, and 15 under the Board of Management, and 20 workers. We have a major challenge with the teaching, that is the teaching human resource, but we have already notified the government the shortage, and we know with the time the government is going to bridge the gap of the teacher shortage that the school is having.
Mark the 60th anniversary of its existence under the stewardship of Mr. Moshina, the principal, Reverend Professor Kabiro Gatumu, the Board of Management chairperson, and Mr. Kaunda, the PAPA chairperson.
Eastern, Western, Eastern, Nyanza. And by the way, I come from Nyanza, from Kisii, and I managed to be the PA chairman in this school. So I love this school. Parents who love this school, because as I've earlier told you, the number of parents was around 500 by 2012. By now we are talking over 850 parents and 967, as you have heard, students, boys in this school. So because of the academic, good academic performance in this school, the number of students has increased. And our facilities have been overstretched. But I thank my parents, my fellow parents, because they have owned the school and they are paying school fees promptly. And even sometimes we are conducting harambees to fund some of the projects, like the dormitory, like the laboratory, like the school bus, school van, generator, all those are being funded by the parents' body, and we are very grateful for the support that we are getting from the parents. And I know by next year again, the population is going to increase, and we are hoping for the best, even as academics is concerned.
We hope to put Kiamutogo on the national academic map with excellence performance in the KCSE exam. Long live Kiamutogo, the home of champions.